Howdy, y'all. I've been listening to a lot of country music lately, and I've come to realise that to be a true southern gal, I need to drive a truck, shoot a gun, and eat buttermilk biscuits and sausage gravy every day. Yes, sirree, Bob. Preheat your oven to 450 normal oven, 410 fan oven. To make the biscuits, I've got a cup of plain flour. Cake flour is particularly good for this because it makes nice soft biscuits. I've got 2.5 tablespoons of vegetable suet, or you could use lard. Here I've got a teaspoon of baking powder, a teaspoon of baking soda, and half a teaspoon of salt, and there's a third of a cup of buttermilk. Sift the dry ingredients, except the suet, obviously, into a bowl. Now add in the suet and work these ingredients together until you get something which is the texture of a coarse meal. Now make a well in the centre, add in the buttermilk and stir briskly with a spoon. If necessary, you can add in an extra teaspoon of buttermilk and mix in. Just work the dough enough to bring everything together. Don't overwork it, otherwise your biscuits will be tough. You see, southern folks may be tough, but when it comes to biscuits, they like them soft. Turn the dough out onto a lightly floured surface, and then with floured hands, pat the dough together, and then press it out to about half an inch thick. Now use a 2-inch cookie cutter to cut out some biscuits and press straight down. And press straight down. Pick up the leftover dough, a bit more flour on the surface, and press out this dough to half an inch thick again. The less you manhandle the dough, the more your biscuits will rise. And I'll get one last biscuit out of this dough. I've transferred the biscuits to a lightly greased baking tray, and I've just brushed the tops with some melted butter. Now I'll pop these in the oven for 12 minutes. Got me some nice flaky looking biscuits here. Now all I need is some sausage gravy. For the sausage gravy, I'm going to start with 250 grams of sausage. And the first thing I'll do is I'll take the skin off the sausage. Now I'll break this sausage into a pan over a medium heat. Just pull bits off and toss them in. It soon starts to sizzle, so stir the sausage around in the pan. Once the sausage is cooked, add in 4 tablespoons of plain flour. Mix in. Once all the flour is incorporated, carefully and slowly add in 2 cups of milk, a bit at a time, stirring in as you go. Once all the milk's added, bring it gently to the boil. As it's coming to the boil, the gravy should start to thicken. Season well with salt and pepper. Mix it one last time and then you're ready to serve. There ain't be no doubt about it. You just gotta love this combination. Yeehaw! This stuff is surprisingly delicious and I could easily get into the country way of life if it wasn't for eating grits and chewing baccy. Anyway, don't forget to join me on Facebook and Twitter and subscribe to this YouTube channel and visit my website titlysbusykitchen.com where you'll find hundreds of recipes from all around the world, including the Deep South. You'll come back now.